really excited today. The latest update to the ChatGPT app for iOS and I assume Android is live, and I'm like a kid in a sweet shop. There's a few updates incoming on the app. The first of them is what I'm going to talk to you about today. In fact, we're just going to give it a go. Because finally, the ChatGPT app, if you've got the pro account that uses a GPT-4, finally has the ability to actually chat to you using voice. And I think this is a huge game changer for how we interact with generative AI. I'm going to give it a go.
So to kick off our chat, could you give me a snapshot of what your business is all about? What's the core mission?
The mission is to help creative and digital businesses achieve success, but achieve success on their own terms by growing the companies in the way that is aligned to their own personal values.
That's really interesting, Phil. The idea of aligning business growth with personal values is such a powerful concept. What challenges have you encountered in helping these creative and digital businesses stick to their values while growing?
Gosh, good question. Growth is always sort of often quite ad hoc in this sector, so it's linked to opportunities. And opportunities don't always align to what people want to do. So one of the big things we work on is really interrogating those ambitions and aspirations of the founders so that there's clarity on the vision, mission and values behind a business that isn't just like a paper exercise. It actually really articulates who they are and what they do and why they do it. So the challenge is sticking to that, and by having alignment to those vision, mission, values, then it's easier to decide what opportunities that come in help them achieve those goals and which don't.
Ah, that makes a lot of sense, Phil. The challenge of aligning ad hoc growth opportunities with a founder's deeper vision and values is quite a balancing act. Given that, have you developed any specific methodologies or tools to help these founders interrogate their own ambitions and sift through these opportunities?
Absolutely. I've got a suite of tools that I've developed, some of which use models that are in the kind of public domain, like the business model canvas, and other parts of that I've kind of developed myself. So we do a lot of work with a diagnostic tool that I've set up at the start, and then we've got workshops that look at individually vision, mission and values from that. The idea being that we take people on this journey that gets them to a stage where they have all of this stuff articulated, they can apply it to the business model canvas, and then we can look at strategic objectives cascading out of that that turn into an implementation plan that delivers against those objectives.
That sounds incredibly comprehensive, Phil. Using both well-known frameworks and your own custom tools gives you the ability to offer a tailored journey. With all these in place, how do you measure the impact of your methods? Do you track specific KPIs or rely on more qualitative measures like client satisfaction?
For my clients, when we deliver an implementation plan that has specific smart objectives within it, so time-based, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-sensitive, which I might have already said, and key KPIs that give you a measure of whether a deliverable or a set of deliverables or targets has been achieved within that. Funnily enough, physician heal thyself, I don't have much in place myself other than regular check-ins with clients post delivery about satisfaction and getting feedback, which tends to be very much on a qualitative basis.
Ah, the classic physician heal thyself situation, eh, Phil? It's quite common in the consulting world, I've heard. It's good you have a robust framework for your clients, but it's also understandable that your own metrics are more qualitative. Given that, have you considered scaling your offerings, perhaps using some kind of automated system that could leverage your existing tools and processes? It could be a way to impact more businesses while staying aligned with your own values.
Mate, that sounds like a cracking idea. I think we will have another question and answer session offline to talk about how perhaps ChatGPT-4 and whatever lies ahead could help me achieve that. But thank you for now. Any last thoughts before we finish the video?
Cheers, Bill. I'm glad you find the idea intriguing. Definitely. Let's dive deeper into how you could leverage AI like me to scale your offerings. That could be a game changer. Last thoughts for the video. Hey, LinkedIn, you've just witnessed how a good chat can lead to actionable insights, even when it's with an AI. Keep an open mind, and who knows what kind of doors will open for you. Thanks for joining us, and remember, the future is what you make of it. What do you reckon, Phil? Shall we wrap it up?
Yeah. I can't believe we're having this conversation here. But that was a very good way to end the video. Thank you very much, ChatGPT. Any of my followers, friends, neighbours, international partners that want to have a chat about anything related to business strategy or AI or both, how you bring the two together, just hit me up with a message.
Absolutely, Phil. It's been a pleasure chatting, and I'm glad we could explore some meaningful topics. And to everyone on LinkedIn, you heard the man. Whether it's business strategy, AI, or a mix of both, Phil's your go-to guy. Don't hesitate to reach out. Cheers for now, and looking forward to our next deep dive. Phil.
Whatever he just said.